Right, everybody, we're on the cuff of Wakefield and Dewsbury today. We're coming to, I think it's called Elkershire Cemetery. I don't know why it's gone right out of my head. We've got some signs here on thing. It's got Commonwealth War Graves, as same as every other graveyard. Please be aware that at Christmas, recent tributes may be removed from the cemetery at the end of February each year. These beautiful gates, everybody. And look at this gorgeous, gorgeous cemetery. We've got some really, really nice stones in here. Some big ones. Just down here. Earl's Heaton, that's it. Earl's Heaton. And it's unusual, everyone, because it's right here on the side of this busy road. And you can see it from right over there. But I think what we're going to do is we're going to start with these big whoppers down here. And then see what other interesting finds we can find. Right, everyone, so we're going to head down these steps now. Some beautiful graves here, look at these.
This must be like the equivalent to that one in Chadder Cemetery, you know, where you come in, all the big mobs
yeah.
are. All
the big uns.
Yeah, all the JPs and councillors and MPs and stuff.
Well, let's have a look here. So we've got...
See, JP.
Yeah.
Lewis Lee, JP.
Earls Heaton. So here we've got Abraham Preston of Earls Heaton, born 1819, died 1892. Also Anne, his wife. We've got Elizabeth Preston. She died 1870, she was only 35. And that's beautiful, that, everybody. Look at it. It's a bit of a dreary day today. It started raining. This is just beautiful. Look at this, everyone. That is gorgeous. And look at the detail here. Little roses. You know what? I bet this would be spectacular if it was all cleaned up. Right, let's have a look at here. Simon just said something interesting, everyone. This was in Grinnaker's. All of this would be punched over by now, because they've done that, haven't they? Across all them tombs. Here we go. Charles Preston, another Preston. JP. The dearly beloved husband of Sally Croft Preston, born April 1858, died 1931, I think, at rest. So this Preston family must have been very prominent in the area, because we've got that one and we've got that one. Oh, look. Oh, this one's got a beautiful tree growing out of it. Look at these gorgeous flowers. I bet they're gorgeous when they're opened up. Right, let's get round this side, because I want to have a look at... looks like they took the monument away from that one. Oh, look at this. The late Helena Augusta Vero, the beloved daughter of Joseph and Ellen Vero, the Earl of Earls Heaton near Dewsbury. She died April 24th, 1863. She was 3 years old, 3 years and 3 months. She is gone to the to the regions of light. She was with us today, she is in heaven tonight. Though to part with our girl, was a trial severe, yet 'tis better that she should be yonder than here. Simon's floated, everyone. I don't know where he's gone. The reading stones. I wanted to show you this here because I think it's beautiful. Look at this. See it? Look, you can see she's got her eyes closed. Look at that. She's praying. Whose grave is this? Frances Goodall of Dewsbury Mills. She died March 12th, 1847. She was 58 and was interred in Ebenezer Burial Ground, Dewsbury. We'll have to go there next. Ebenezer Burial Ground. You know, actually, I think I looked at that and it's a bloody car park now. We'll have to have a look. I'll try and remember, everyone. Also, Judith, widow of the... Oh, it's a fella, Francis. Right. Also, Judith, widow of the above, who died at Banktop, Soothill, Nether, January 28th, and was interred here. Also in loving remembrance of Frank Goodall, son of the above. It's a beautiful grave, this one. But this one's got a different look on face. Is it beautiful, everyone? Look. Right, let's get round here. Can you hear them birds? You know what? I'd love to have one of them houses, me. I could look out onto the graveyard every day then. You know, here's another. Well, you've got the Barraclough's up there. And you've got more here. You've got Percy Barraclough. He was of Savile Town, Dewsbury, and he died July 2nd, 1929.
Let's get back to these, see what we can find.
Oh. Hey, this is unusual. Look how that's been carved out. It's almost like they've made a mistake and carved it out to recarve it. Clark and Anna Lee Pierce of Earls Heaton died. Clark and Hannah Lee Pierce, they both died. Oh, aged 2 years and 2 months. They must have been twins. Oh, no. That don't make sense, does it? They both died at the same time. They're both same age. Must have been twins. What's the story behind that? Am I seeing that wrong, everyone? And we've also got Fanny, wife of James Pierce. Spelt wrong, look. P-E-R-C-E. P-E-A-R-C-E. So they cocked up. Bloody hell. Look, everybody. What's happened with this one is there's a packet of sun in down there. Not sunning, whatever it's called, that drink you used to get in a packet. Calypso Sun, is it? And you've got that that's been thrown down there. Sam, beloved husband of Anne Bailey, died 1955, aged 66, also the above named Anne Bailey. Died 1969. I wonder if the relatives know that this is the case. Everybody, we're in Wakefield. We've come to Wakefield Cemetery. I want to start by showing you this. We're going to go over this side. This is the old side. But I want to start by showing you these beautiful blossom trees because they're absolutely stunning. Look at it. It's a tree-lined avenue of blossom trees. I think that's absolutely beautiful, everybody. Look at that. Blossom trees are my favourite anyway. Don't they turn into cherries then? I'm sure cherry trees blossom. Look at it. Anyway, this is the new part. So first of all, we've got two. I don't know if that's a grave or if that's a chapel. That's a chapel, which is obviously closed a long time ago. Is that a grave? Plaques. It is a grave, isn't it?
Like I said, the Clash tree, who it was memorialising,
they've gone.
They've disappeared.
Oh, this one's got a little bit of writing on. Oh, what a shame, everybody. So it is a grave. This is the biggest. This is the biggest grave I've ever seen in my life. Yeah. I mean, it's literally the size of a building, everyone. You just can't read it, can you? In loving memory of, and you just can't.
It's you just sworn, hasn't it?
Yeah, you just can't see it. What a bleeding shame. Whose grave is this? I bet I can find out. I mean, something is. Look at that. Someone's still bringing tributes. Maybe. See under this. Under this ivy, there may be some more plaques. It's took over, isn't it? This is why I don't like ivy. just eats everything. Remember when I had to go to, I don't know if you do remember everybody, but when I went to, what's it called, Robert Ashcroft's grave, and it was eating that as well. Well, I'll have to go to Google and see if I can find out whose grave this is, because I certainly won't be able to tell you myself. What a shame. Look, it's got like a rose, and it's got like some sort of sunflower, and then it's got, look at these heads, beautiful. Right, let's have a look round then. So there you go, the biggest grave that I've actually ever seen there.
What's that there? Is it a dead pigeon?
Ooh, is it a dead pigeon?
No, what is it?
It's a dead pigeon. Oh, look, everyone.
What's it doing up there?
No, never.
Can't you zoom in on it?
No. They must live in there. Can you see that, everyone? That's absolutely revolting. Oh, God. We're walking through barns the other day, me, mother and Simon, and there was a dead pigeon on the side at straight out with aisle. Hey, look at this. The sob. Oh, the barn. Trob. And barn. Let's have a look at these big ones over here, everybody. See, there's a plaque here on this. See, this puzzles me, everyone, why it looks like a dump. So this says, in loving memory of Joe Kilner of Wakefield, who died June 29th, 1896. He was 35 years old. Now, that's not his grave, so they've moved that and put it here for some reason. And it said here, blessed are the bread... Sorry, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. That grave there, everyone, has got pigeons living in it. Look at them going in. Ugh, dirty gets. I don't like them, me. There's some beautiful graves around here, everyone. Hang on, I need to fasten this coat up, I'm freezing. Simon's just pointed this out, everybody. Let's just go back over, well. Remember what that cellar's called, hang on.
Same rock formation.
It is the same rock formation, and it's had something snapped off top, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, well, hang on, there's a cross here that's on floor that would have stood on it, look. Benjamin Watson, JP, August 1896. Mary Watson, 1899. Yeah. George Perkin. Look at this, everybody. Simon's just found this one. George Perkin, gravestone letterer, Wakefield.
Wonder if he did his own.
Yeah, he might have done. Died June 17th, 1897. Also, Bridget, his wife. Gravestone letterer. It's like that artist in... there's one down here I wanted to walk to. And then some of these that we're going to come back to on the way back up. What do you think of Wakefield Cemetery, everybody? I think it's actually quite marvellous. I really like those. Look at them, you can see them from over here. Those beautiful blossoms. I love blossom trees. That's the one I wanted to look at. Here we go, everybody. The Rhodes grave. In memory of William Rhodes, Mayor of Wakefield, 1903 to 1904, who died in that, so he was obviously mayor until he died. And look, the mural chains are on the stone, everybody.
Yeah,
he died in...
Or is it a chicken?
He died in... Well, all right, we know it's just fallen off. So what does it say, that he died in... serving God and his city?
Because of all the chicken, serving God and his
city. I don't think we should laugh, do you? And then we've got Annie Louisa Rhodes, widow of the aforesaid William Rhodes. She died 1926. She lived a long time without him. we'll be able to get a nice picture of William, I'm sure. And also, William Harris Rhodes, the eldest son of the late William Rhodes. That poor bugger died in 1911, age 38. Let's have a look over here, everybody. These gravestones have been taken by the ivy. They need cutting back, really. That needs sorting. See, this is why I said don't introduce ivy in your house, Simon, because look, this is what happens. Let's have a look at these, everybody. Yeah, I don't like how that's took hold, that those bushes, they get on my wick. This is badly decayed, this one. George Henry. Can't see its surname. See, this is where the ivy has been removed, everybody, because you can see where it started to eat into the stone. This would have been all ivy eating over. So they've cleared this one. Edwin, son of Martin and Martha Wormald of Wakefield, who died at the Isle of Man, September 1862, was 16. Also Alfred Stocks, their son. Martin, age 48, he died 1866. Maybe she remarried. Myers Peter Kowski of Wakefield, he died 1879. Born 1822, also Annie's wife. This is an interesting one down here. What's that one, Si? Looks like it's got a book on the top of it. See that, everybody? Maybe that's the Bible.
It's a good Bible, isn't it?
Yeah.
Doncaster Road.
Jonas Jowett of Doncaster Road, born 1801, died 1887. And Elizabeth Ann, widow of the above, lived on Doncaster Road. I'm going to be able to find some good histories today, everybody. Some spectacular ones, I hope. I hope. I want to go to this one here.